Hello, everyone. Counting the cost of COVID, Alberta's spree of conversion therapy bylaws continues. Why are we so worried about reopening churches anyway? And don't forget the We Need a Law store is open. It's Wednesday, July 8th, and this is Quick Updates. BC manager Levi Minderhout has published several articles on the question of counting the cost of COVID. He joins us now.
Hi, everyone. So we all know that the federal government has spent a lot of money to combat COVID-19. The Parliamentary Budget Office estimates that the deficit this year will exceed $250 billion, or a quarter of $1 trillion. In terms of a percentage of GDP, that is a deficit larger than at any time in Canada's history, except for World War II. That's astounding. But what should we think of as Christians and as Canadian citizens about this? Is the government spending too much? Well, yes and no. It's inevitable that the government would have to go into deficit in response to COVID-19. There's no way to get around that. But if the government had better designed its programs, made it more targeted, and better administered them, that could greatly reduce the size of Canada's overall deficit. So if you haven't read our series, Counting the Cost of COVID, go on our website and check out those blog posts. Back to you, Colin.
Thanks, Levi. Next up, Alberta's municipalities continue to lead the way with the seemingly new fad of passing conversion therapy bylaws. Here's Ed with more.
Hey, thanks, Colin. Well, another conversion therapy update, this time Lethbridge, Alberta, another proposed conversion therapy bylaw that defines conversion therapy and business so broadly that it would punish Christian teachers and pastors and counselors for teaching basic Christian sexual ethics. Southern Alberta supporters, here's what you can do. First, you can join me in Lethbridge Saturday, July 11 at 8 o'clock p.m. for a prayer meeting at the Amazing Grace Community Church. Secondly, you can email city councilors and the clerk asking for the date of the public hearing. Third, you can use our easy mail system and send an easy mail urging Lethbridge City Council to oppose this proposed bylaw. Fourth, you can express support for councillors Joe Morrow and Blaine Higgin for upholding a free exchange of ideas in the democratic process in requesting a public hearing. And finally, of course, you can pray that God would soften the hearts of our city councillors and make the wise decision. God bless. Back to you, Colin.
Thanks so much, Ed. We've been spending a lot of time on this question of reopening churches across the country. Last week, Levi had an opinion piece published in the Chilliwack Progress and several other newspapers. I was really struck particularly by this quote, quote, "Just as medical treatment is to the injured, food is to the hungry, and work is to the unemployed, so the participation in collective worship services, hearing the preaching of God's word, receiving baptism, participating in Holy Communion, praising God collectively in song and prayer, and fellowshipping with other believers is to the spiritually deprived Christian." Unquote. Now, as ARPA Canada, we've come alongside you, our supporters, in seeking to obey both the command of God to respect those in authority, but also the call God places on us to come together in worship, a constitutionally protected freedom in our country. Now, this issue continues as churches remain under tough and changing restrictions. It's important to continue to dialogue with our leaders on this issue. We've updated our easy mail letters, different ones depending on which province you live in, on this subject of reopening churches. You can send one today at easy.arpacanada.ca. Finally, here's a message from the We Need a Law team.
Thanks, Colin. We are thrilled with the response that we've received to the We Need a Law store. If you haven't had a chance to check out our new designs, we encourage you to do so quickly. The store is closing this Friday, July 10th. Check it out at store.weneedalaw.ca.
That's all for this week. If you have a grassroots story or action video that you'd like to share with us, let us know at info@arpacanada.ca. Thanks for watching Quick Updates. Please do like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.